Booming Thunder Radio. Where we groove as the spirit moves. Yeah. Drawing the honey from the rock. With the righteous Reverend Doctor on Booming Thunder Radio. Seek first the kingdom of light, and the righteousness of the Son of Glory. May he be in each of our hearts this day. May the living word, the love, a soul full of love, a heart full of soul, a wanting for the word of truth to enter, opening the door, a wanting for the key in the keyhole, and the turning of the tumblers of the lock. That the grand and beautiful gate. Doorknobs in our right hand, and in our left as a red sea, the living word revealed before each of us this day, brings forth the mystery of heaven, in men's hearts that do not forget, and in ways of everlasting glory. With a hope, like Issachar, like a green-eyed lady, like a Bengal tiger. As the booming thunder of the Father comes forth. Now, today's number is 655. So let's open our east sword. Open up our lexicons. My favorite is the word study, but the Brown Driver is very good for the Old Testament, and the Thayer for the New Testament. Those are the three-bound chord I use most of the time. So today is H655. Oh, look, y'all. The Hebrew 655 is a masculine noun. It means open. It means, well, it's spoken as open. And in the Hebrew, it sounds like open in the English. Open, obad. One day I'll have a brother that'll teach me these things the way the Father had wanted them to teach their whole lives with the spirit of truth in their heart. An army beyond measure, unseen in a world beyond imagination. Masculine noun meaning the right time, the right circumstance. Refers to the proper time for appropriate words to be used. Like Proverbs 25 and 11. Like a bushel basket of apples. Like at apples of gold in settings of silver. There's a word spoken in right circumstances. The boom and thunder and the rain is heard outside. Now, if we were to step forward into this radiant world of Mystery Babylon, the Greek world of 655, what do we find? We find those that are contracted. Apostukio. Apostugo. It comes from Apo G575. Which is deserting against, among, going after. It has many meanings, like a weaver's work. It is the root of this word, but it means to hate. Arbor, detest with horror, such as described in Romans 12:9. Let love be without hypocrisy. Arbor what is evil, cling to what is good. Hallelujah. It also is a derivative of G2319, Theostugis, which is haters of God. The synonym is to turn away from or to deflect, to bear off, hold oneself off or refrain, to arbor, detest the shuddering, to push away from the wicked things. The anagram, to have compassion and be touched. Yeah. Touched with a feeling. Yeah. Go find that song. Touched by feeling today. Let it rock your heart. Let it make you cry just a little bit in your soul. Yeah. So the G55 in the Thayer is to dislike or have a horror of. Yeah. To be hated because they hate you so much because you can send them into the lake of fire forever with a word. Yeah, you have already done it, and they are too blind to see the smoking fingers, yeah, in the hand of their smoking guns. So the Brown Driver Briggs lexicon on the Hebrew 655, ophan, it is a noun, a masculine noun for circumstance, condition, or timely. From an unused root meaning to revolve. Yeah, I hope you can dig all that. It's a lot of numbers, a lot of mystery. But you know how I am. I love seeing how the Father weaves this in a mysterious way into each of our hearts. Yeah, just the knowing that He the faithful one, the one who is going to do these things for us. Each of us. So today, do you have her in your hand? The living word between the palms of your hands? And you opened her up to page 655 or thereabouts? And she revealed, wisdom opened her pages to each of us. 1 Chronicles, chapter 7. And this is the genealogy of some of the treasured sons of the spiritual tribes of Israel, y'all. I hope y'all can dig that. Because there's a lot of twisted up kind of words in here. And the translators didn't do us any favors. Perhaps they did, and I just don't understand it yet. But it appears doubtful. So we're going to do something a little bit different, because it's the deeper meaning in the depths of the ocean. That pressure you feel going to the deep to find the truth. That's what we're going to do today. So we would normally read from our New American Standard. The sword of glory pierces each and every day. But the gin, a manifestation, manifest in your heart. We'll read from our scabbarded e-sword this day. And in so doing, we can quickly see all the strong man's depths. The brown driver briggs upon each name, so we can see the mystery of heaven. First let us see it in the descendants of Issachar. Those men knew the times and knew what should be done. Now the sons of Issachar, were four. Tola, and Tola is from the same as H8438, two men of Issachar. Not really much on that. So let's go to the lexicon there and see if we can figure out how we can do this easier than what it appears we can. I see. It's an 8439A, so I gotta get rid of that. So we take the A off of it, and we run that through our lexicon. And it is the first son of Issachar and the head of his clan. The name of a judge in Israel. He was son of Pua. He was from the city of Shamir. That's not a bad place in the hill country of Ephraim. He delivered Israel 23 years. Indeed. Yeah, Judges 10:1. Now after Abimelech died, Tola, the son of Pua, the son of Dodo, a man of Issachar, arose to save Israel, and he lived in Shemir. Yea, he had a stone in each hand in the hill country of Ephraim. Hallelujah. And the Greek mindset. Well, now let's see what the Brown says. That was the word study. Brown. Oh, you ain't going to believe what the word Tola means. That was a hard thing to get to. Figure out what that name means, was it not? But we found it in the old Brown Driver Bridge, y'all. It's real plain. It's the worm. Yeah. The same as 84:38. A worm, scarlet stuff, crimson. A worm, the female, Caucus illicis. Scarlet stuff, crimson, scarlet, the dye made from the dried body of the female of the worm, Caucus illicis, worm or maggot, worm or grub, the worm, Caucus illicis. Crimson, purple, and worms. Yes, this word Tola. Yeah, 84:38 used three times that way. Maggots, it's just not the kind of name I want to have. You know, what is going on with our treasured Issachar's first son to lead the clan that knows the crimson red Issachar? You hearing the spirit too, brother? Yeah, are you seeing the night or the day light? So the next son of Issachar, this might take us a few days to get through. We might have to change our methods here. Pua, H6312, meaning splendid. The next son, Jasib, means he will return. And Shimron, yes. From something that they definitely don't want us to know about, because they make it difficult, but it is, Shimron means watch height. The fourth son of Issachar and the progenitor of the family of Shimronites. A Canaanite, royal city allotted to Zebulun. That's interesting. So the sons of Tola were Uzi, Rephaiah, Jeriel, Jamiel, Ibsam, and Samuel, heads of their father's households, each one. So Uzi means strong. Raphia means healed of Yehovah. Jeriel means taught by God. Jami means whom Yehovah guards. Ibsam, pleasant. And Samuel, oh, you know what that name is. His name is El. So of Tola, mighty men of valor in their generations, you can see it in their names. Their number in the days of David was 22,600. Yeah. And the sons of Uzi were Izrahiah. The son of Uzi, the strong one, was Izrahiah, which means Yehovah will shine. And the sons of Izariah were Michael, Obadiah, Joel, Ishiah, and five of them were chief men. Yea. Michael means who is like God. Obadiah means servant of Yehovah. Joel means Yehovah is God. And Isaiah means Yehovah will lend. Yeah, and they were all five burning candles, chief men. Yeah, chief cornerstones, some of them in their own homes. With them by their generations, according to their fathers' households, were 36,000 troops of the army for war, for they had many wives and sons. Their relatives among all the families of Issachar, mighty men of valor, enrolled by genealogy, in all, there were 87,000 men of war and their families, bringing forth the troops of the 36,000. But what of the end from the beginning? Yea, the descendants of Benjamin. Yeah, the sons of Benjamin were three. Bela, Becher, and Jediel. Bela means destruction. First son of Benjamin, a king of Edom, and a son of Ahazaz, a Reubenite. One of the five cities of the plain which was spared at the intercession of Lot and received the name of Zoar. Destruction. Almost unbelievable. Benjamin would name his oldest son Destruction. Would he name his second son? What does it mean? A young camel. Ephraim named his son Becher also. And Jediel, God makes known. Yeah, this one was a chief patriarch in the tribe of Benjamin. And Iri, belonging to a city. Yeah. Well, and were heads of fathers' households, mighty men of valor, and were 22,034. Enrolled by genealogy. Now the sons of Becher, yeah, were Zimiara, Joash, Elazar, Elionia, Omri, Jeremoth, Abijah, Anathah, and Alameth. All these were the sons of Becher. Wow, he had a bunch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 sons. Zemera means song. Joash means Yehovah hastens. Elazar means God is help. Elionia is a little more difficult to determine. It means unto Yehovah are my eyes. Omri, pupil of Yehovah. Jeremoth means he is most high. Abijah, Yehovah is my father. Anathoth answers to prayer. And Elameth means covering. All these were the sons of Becher. They were enrolled by genealogy according to their generations, heads of their fathers' households, 20,200 mighty men of valor. The sons of Jediel was one Bilhan, and his name means their decrepitude. Descendant of Esau, decrepitude, their decrepitude, what a name to receive from your father. And the sons of Bila were Jeush, Benjamin, Ued, Chinyana, Zethan, Tarshish, and Ashara. Some of those don't sound too good, y'all. He hurries to aid. Benjamin means son of the right hand. Ued means I will give thanks. I will be praised. Or undivided union. Give thanks. I will be praised. You had Chinia, traitor, false prophet of Ahab, also had that name. Zethan, an olive. These are all Hebrew meanings. Tarshish, yellow, jasper. city somewhere near the accessible to the Red Sea, to which ships constructed at Ezion Geber on the Atlantic Gulf on the Red Sea were to sail. Yellow jasper. Very interesting, isn't that? Ahashiara, my brother is Dawn, or brother of the Dawn, a Benjaminite. Yeah. All these were the sons of Jediel, according to the heads of their father's household, 17,200 mighty men of valor, who were ready to go out with the army to war. Shupin and Hupin, yeah, they were the sons of Ur. Shupin means serpents, and Hupin means protected. And they were the sons of Ar, belonging to a city, a protected snake of the city. Yeah, Hushim. Which, who makes haste, he was the son of Ayer, and Ayer means following. The descendants of Naphtali, the sons of Naphtali were Jaziel, Guni, Jezer, and Shalom. Jaziel, God divides. Guni, my defender. Jezer, forming. Shalom, retribution. The sons of Bilna. Little Bilna. Bila means troubled. Yeah, Rachel's handmaid, whom she gave to Jacob as a concubine, mother to two of Jacob's children, Dan and Naphtali. Now, the descendants of Manasseh, the sons of Manasseh were Azrael, whom his Aramean concubine bore. She bore Machir, the father of Gilead. Machir means soul, and Gilead means rocky region. Makur took a wife for Hupim, yeah, the serpent, and Shupim, the protected one, whose sister's name was Maka, yeah, pressure. She has pressed, yeah, like the wine presser. Receiving the wine dresser's work. And the name of the second, yeah, was Zelophehad, which means firstborn. Interesting how the second was the firstborn by name. And that was my son saying he'll be looking out for that kind of honey that's got a little bit of comb in it, you know, makes your hair So, Maka, the wife of Makor, bore a son, and she named him Perish. Perish, which means dung. Are you kidding me? This woman named her son from Makor. I guess, she sold herself, and this son came, and now she named him Poop, you know. Merciful Father. Poor son. His whole life with a burden like that. Never knowing it. And the name of his brother, was Sheresh. And it means root. So one was dung and one was a root. Was she trying to fertilize her plain, her miracle valley some way? And her sons were, and Sheresh's sons were Ulam and Rakam. Ulam means their leader, vestibule. And Rakam means their variegation. Interesting. The son of Ulam was Badan, and Badan means in judging. These were the sons of Gilead. Yeah, the rocky place, the rocky region. The son of Makur, yeah, the one sold. And the son of Manasseh, yeah, the one causing the elephants to forget. His sister Hamolach bore Ishad and Abazur and Mayala. So I know I'm butchering these names, but we're looking them up. That's what's important. Put the meaning in your heart. Hamolsheth means the queen. Ishad means man of majesty. Abazur, my father is help. And Mala, disease. The sons of Shemida were, Shemida means wise, were Aeon, brotherly or fraternal, and Shechem, back, or could mean shoulder. And Laki, which means learning. And Anaam, which means I am the people, or lament of people. Yeah, tribe of Manasseh. Now the descendants of Ephraim, the sons of Ephraim were, and Ephraim, you know what it means, right? Double ash heap. I shall be doubly fruitful. Hallelujah. Yeah, the sons of Ephraim were Shuthelah and Bered. The sons Tehath. His sons Eladath, his sons Tathans, his son. Oh man, and their descendants? Man, they had a lot of descendants. I'm going to let you Oh, look at Asher. Oh, look at old Asher. What's he up to? Oh, he's always happy. He has his water. Yeah. He has his feet in the water, sitting on the dock of a bay. You watching the tide rolling go away, yeah. Sitting on the dock of a bay, wasting time. So I'm going to let you boys and you treasured queens of the earth, having received the treasured seed from your King of Glory that brings forth the sons in your heart, yeah, like no other generation upon the earth, transfigured in the twinkling of an eye. Yeah. What was that? That was the oven door. Yeah, we're going into the kitchen now, y'all. You know what that means, don't you? Yeah, it's time to draw the sword and cut a piece. Yeah, another slice of Hebrew pie. Putting the blade right in the center, all the way to the hilt. Drawing it straight, radial, yeah, squaring off the arc, the rippling at the ends, yeah, the burnt pieces flaking off, yeah, the miracle whip, let it go on. Hebrew pie, a sweet slice, a number 24. Yeah, HebrewPie.com. Search in the upper menu for two faithful witnesses. Go down to the first block of letters on this pie day and know that more. Merciful hand of our Father to give us these blessings to share with you all. Yeah, Hebrew Pie 1969. If it be the will of the Father, may it come forth. Glory and honor, a Hanukkah warrior sword raised on high, a double portion in the library once again. Yeah, but until that time, let us look at the sum of Hebrew Pie 24, knowing that we are looking at an emerald. Yeah, and then a ruby, like a pear, with the color of an apple. I'll let y'all click on the ruby and feel the heat from the flaming sword of glory and get the right sum. I still haven't got back and corrected my errors and my summations in the pages, but in the PDFs, in the clicking of the pictures, you'll always get the right sum number. Forgive me and pray for me that I'll have strength to get these done very soon as we add, yeah, the latter rain that has now come. This day with the merciful hand of the Father, the will of the Father, may it come forth this day. But until then, here's Hebrew Pi 24, knowing the spiritual blood, yea, the blood spilt is Yahshua's we speak of, yea, never natural blood of a carnal mind or a carnal hand, the unseen world of Yahshua's blood.
Surrounded with divine support.
Yes, we are. So let us begin at the beginning, shall we?
Gushing forth blood. Take forth the sickle at your perfect time. Divide the wheat from the chaff, for it shall soon be the appointed time. Mighty is the wind that gathers those who hear. Open up the door, for Yahovah and his kingdom are near. The outside is bitter, full of chaos, killing and crime. The commander-in-chief of our land has broken the trust and is heralding in the end of many lives. They come to surround us, to divide the power that dwells inside. Each has only goodness and mercy to beat back the darkness of this time. Our weapon for war is his word that's been written upon our hearts. Wield a mighty sword, cutting deep, gushing forth blood from many hearts. As a dangling ear in Gethsemane, the reapers come forth for the harvest after the latter rain. Yahovah sends forth the Lamb with authority. Mashiach comes teaching all things, yea, those deep things, the secrets brought forth by the latter rain. We stand in the mud, in worship and praise. We're surrounded with divine support. The breath of Yah reveals the tabernacle that now unites us in a mighty, mighty way.
Yea, hallelujah, mighty friends. Yea, pray for us in the glorious studio to come forth that we can, yea, write the books in our heart, can manifest the songs upon the organ, and, yea, and the harp. Yea, the glory of God in each of our hearts, knowing the cream and the sunshine of each of our love for him who created all. Always will and always has, in the end, overcome.